Hola.
Hola.
Bienvenidos a Lightspeed Spanish.
Bienvenidos.
This week we continue with the test, but this time es la parte chunga. Yeah?
La parte chunga.
B1, B2
you
of the C2.
You can do it.
Okay. So.
Even beginners should try it.
Yeah.
You know, even if it's really hard, just try it to see, just to check the level.
Just to see, there might be some that you'll get.
Yeah, for sure. There'll be some that.
Pues nos vemos en la segunda parte. Que conste que yo no he visto las respuestas, ¿vale? Entonces ya
no,
todo
él,
es un...
él puede ver las opciones, pero no hay indicación de cuál es la correcta.
He visto las preguntas.
Sí.
¿Vale? Y dos de ellas me dan miedo. ¿Vale? Pero vamos a ver.
No sé, ellas me dan miedo. No, de olvidar Hopcoin. Oh my God, mucho más. Vale.
Ok.
Número 11. Por favor, no... Por aquí. A. Corras. B. Corre. C. Correr.
So for me it's got to be A. Corras. Because the other two don't fit in. There's a command and if it was usted it would be no corra. So it's got to be corras, yeah?
Exactly, because it's a command.
It's a command, yeah.
However, because it's a command in disguise, in English, because you said... Don't run. People, sometimes they go, oh, run. Correr.
Correr.
Correr, yeah. Because there's no person. Correr. Yeah. But it's a command, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Vale, número 12. ¿Te acuerdas de tu tía Sofía? ¿Tu tía Sofía?
Mm-hmm.
¿De tu tía Sofía?
Rima.
A. Sí, si me recuerdo. B. Sí, si recuerdo. C. Sí, sí me acuerdo.
Okay. So I would choose sí. Sí, me acuerdo.
Correcto.
Only because that's what the question's asking. Te acuerdas, not... Okay. So, and... Sí, sí, recuerdo. Me recuerdo.
Me recuerdo is wrong. Me recuerdo is
I remember myself.
Me recuerdo.
Yeah.
I remember myself.
Yeah.
You could say, I remember myself when I was a kid,
sí.
Blah, 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 blah.
Uh-huh.
Okay, you could do that. But we're talking about somebody else. So you can't remember yourself, you have to remember her.
Yeah.
Recuerdo. I remember. That's the trick, because in English you would say, oh yeah, I remember.
Yeah.
But it's, no. Recuerdo, if something, la recuerdo, I remember her.
Yeah.
Yes, so that would be
okay.
not good. It wouldn't be correct.
Mm-hmm.
I'll say that because in the comments they'll say, oh, I put B, is that correct? No.
No.
Me acuerdo. And also in the question, ¿te acuerdas?
It's, yeah.
Me acuerdo.
And it's acordarse de.
Me acuerdo de ella, mm-hmm. ¿Sí? O la recuerdo.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Número 13. ¿Quién a estas horas de la noche... And estas horas, that's good, isn't it?
Instead of esta hora.
Uh-huh. Estas horas. A estas horas de la noche. A. Llamo. B. Llama. C. Llame.
Okay, so I'm going for B. Llama. ¿Quién llama?
So
because, first of all, llamo is I call, so that's not the right person. And quién is third person, who? Third person, so we go for third person.
Mm-hmm.
It's not a subjunctive trigger.
No, and also to be able to use the E, llamo, it would be a quién llamo, who am I calling at this time? Who am I calling instead of who's calling?
Right, yeah,
¿sí? Vale, número 14, muy bien, Gordon. Esta mañana... Okay, now we have three
mm-hmm.
gaps.
Mm-hmm.
Esta mañana temprano de casa, pero que volver porque el móvil. A. Salía, tenía, me dejaba. B. Salí, tuve, me había dejado. C. Salí, tenía, me lo dejé.
We'll give you a little bit more time because this is a bit more involved. Okay, so I'm going for B. Salí, tuve, me había dejado.
Okay, that's correct. Why B?
Right, because there are certain things. Right, so in the A, we're using all the imperfect. Salía, tenía, but this is not describing. This is saying events. It's a list of stuff that happened.
Exactly.
That's when we use
it's
the preterite.
Like action done.
Action, action dum, done. Dum, dum. And the last one doesn't me lo dejé.
You can't have the law because then you say el móvil.
El móvil, exactly.
So
yeah.
You can have law and el móvil.
Yeah.
Because it's the same thing.
Either me dejé el móvil o me lo dejé.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Muy bien. Entonces, la B, correcto.
How did he do with that one? Did he get it? It was tough, that one.
That was tough, yeah. Número 15. Qué bien que Esther ese trabajo. A. Consigue. B. Conseguía. C. Haya conseguido.
Okay, so the answer for me is C, haya conseguido. The reason is because A, the verb is conseguir, and que bien que is a trigger for the subjunctive, so it's got to be consiga, at least. So that doesn't fit. Conseguía is the imperfect, that doesn't fit either, because we've got a trigger for the subjunctive, so the only option is haya conseguido.
Perfecto, Gordon, buena explicación. Número 16. Daniel y Tomás, la cena, por favor. A. Terminaos. B. Termina. C. Terminar.
Okay. So I'm going to go for A. Terminaos.
Okay.
Because there are two of them, so we've got to use vosotros. So B won't fit because that's the singular. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and terminar isn't a command in the vosotros.
Exactly, form. This is a command, no? Like,
yeah,
finish your dinner.
Exactly.
But why os though?
Because you want them to eat it all up, mm-hmm. And so we use the emphasis se.
Okay.
It's used for emphasis, like, yeah, finish, like, it all up.
Exactly, like when we say comerse, cenarse, desayunarse. In reflexive,
yeah.
When it's like, I finished,
yeah,
like, finish, yeah, the meal. Or when you're talking about the quantity.
Yeah.
Or in this case, finish your meal, which is also to eat something up, yeah?
Yeah.
Muy bien. So, hence, termina os. Os is the reflexive. Mm-hmm. And without the reflexive, if it wasn't reflexive,
okay, that would
how
be
would it be?
Terminad.
Terminad.
With a D.
D.
Yeah.
Because it's two people.
Yeah.
17. Perdona. Qué raro que Román no estuviera esta mañana. A. Estará ocupado. B. Estaría ocupado. C. Estarás ocupado. So this is an answer to the first statement, ¿sí?
Okay. So this is the one that I was the answer for me is B, estaría ocupado, because I've heard them use the conditional to talk about where he probably was in the past, whereas the estará is referring to what he's up to, like, going forward, not talking about the past.
Exactly. So here we're talking about the past. So how strange that he wasn't here this morning. So that's gone. So now I'm thinking about why he wasn't here.
Yeah.
So we would say, oh, he would have been, or he would be.
He would be. It's not something we would say in English.
No, you wouldn't
what
say
they
this
do
in English.
Here.
But when we're referring to something that we're thinking about, something that maybe happened in the past, the reason why, we would use the conditional.
Yeah.
But if we're in that time and somebody's saying, how strange that he's not here, then I'll use the future. Or he'll be busy.
Yeah. Just okay, as we
so
would in
he'll
English.
He'll be busy.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's why he's not coming now. Or if we're talking about the past, he would be busy.
And we would
I know
say
it
probably
in English.
He would have been busy. he was probably busy, something like that, yeah?
Yeah, so that's something different in English and Spanish.
Yeah, doesn't translate.
So future for something that you're thinking about in the present and conditional for something that you're thinking about, something that happened in the past, yeah?
Yeah.
18. Conocido a mis amigos, sí, conmigo a comer. A. Hubieses venido. B. Habrías venido. C. Hubieras venido.
Okay, so I'm going to go for A. Habrías conocido a mis amigos si hubieras venido, no, conmigo.
A doesn't have hubieras.
¿Eh? O hubieses.
Eso es.
Sorry.
Just because the C does have hubieras. So it's the A.
Yeah. And I've chosen that one because of the rule, and it's the one that you can remember. Si era. When you've got the C in this structure, you're always going to have the imperfect subjunctive. Iera, iese, ara, ase. That's how it has to go with the C. You can't mix it round.
Exactly.
And the other ones are mixing it round. Well, the last one's a classic error as well, isn't it?
Exactly. And what is the difference between hubieras and hubieses?
None.
There's no difference. You can use both. Okay? So you hubieras venido, hubieses venido. Okay? They're both correct. But the last one is not correct because of the hubieses at the beginning. 19. Puedes ir bici, pie o ir caballo. A. En A. En B. En D. A. C. En A. A.
Give you a little bit of time for that one. It's a bit more complex. Okay.
When he's giving you time, he's giving himself time, I think.
Mm-hmm.
He's like, I'll give you more time, but
now, this is the one that I was scared of, okay? Because, so, I'm between A and C, all right? Because I'm going to, so, puedes ir en bici, that's absolutely certain. A pie, absolutely certain. But then we've got, I'm going for a caballo or en caballo.
Okay, which one? If you had to choose,
right?
Like, because instinct.
Because I've got ir, normally the preposition a goes with ir, right?
Yeah, but you've got ir en bici.
I know. So that's what's thrown me because I know it's montar a caballo, ir en caballo. So would it be A?
No, it would be C.
Man!
Ir a caballo.
A caballo.
I mean, can you hear ir en caballo? Yes, but it's the right way would be a caballo.
I thought it was montar a caballo.
Montar a caballo.
And then ir en caballo.
Ir a caballo.
A caballo. But there you are, you see?
That's but also, why. I'm sure some people say ir en caballo.
Okay.
But the right...
A caballo. Okay, there
so
you
what
are.
About, why is it not B?
De pie.
Mm-hmm.
Because de pie is estar de pie, to be standing, to be on foot. So it's not movement. It's a stationary place. Yeah?
Muy bien, exactly. Y la última, número 20. Hacía 20 años que... A. Te veo por última vez. B. No te veía. C. Te vi.
Okay, this is a really interesting one. I had to think about this one. But because we're not saying hace, we're saying hacía. We're
saying
in the
hace.
Past.
Mm-hmm.
So the answer for me would have to be B, que no te veía.
Correcto.
Yeah. But hace 20 años que no te veo, present.
Hace 20 años que no te veo.
Hacía 20 años que no te veía.
Which, again, is not the typical structure in English. You wouldn't say, it's been 20 years that I don't see you. That's what we say.
Yeah.
I haven't seen you. You would say, since I saw you last.
Since I saw you last, I haven't seen you for 20 years.
Yes, so we would say, it was 20 years since I saw, since that I didn't see you.
Yeah, exactly.
Or
yeah.
It's 20 years that I don't
and
see
you. And I hadn't seen you for 20 years. That's how we would say it in the past.
Yeah. Muy bien. Mm-hmm. So, muy bien. Ve que no te veía. Hacía 20 años que no te veía. O hace 20 años que no te veo. Mm-hmm. And I have an extra one, un punto extra.
Okay.
Okay. El hombre al vimos ayer es mi ex. A. ¿Qué? B. ¿Quién? C. ¿Qué?
Okay, so the one that only one that sounds right to me is A. Al que vimos.
Okay, so well, definitely C is not, because that would be a question.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. But why not quién? Because it's who, yeah? So why not quién?
Because we've got the el in this, a el.
A el.
Yeah. A el que.
A el que. Muy bien.
So could you say, I don't say, no sé, if you can say a quién?
Ajá, el hombre a quién. A quién, but not sí. Al. ¿Quién? Because we've got the el,
yeah.
So then it would be a, al, que.
Yeah.
O a la que, if
exactly.
It was a woman.
Mm-hmm.
Muy bien, Gordon, ¿eh? Buen trabajo. Muy bien, pues has sacado 19 puntos.
19, no, punto extra,
20. Con el punto extra, extra 20, muy bien.
Y sí, podría haber sacado 21 puntos, pero
sí,
no.
Pero bueno.
Bueno, a caballo, en caballo. A caballo. A ver, ¿qué es? A caballo.
A caballo.
Sí. No, sí, en caballo. Vale. Bien. Montar a caballo, ir a caballo.
Pero, no sé por qué, porque luego en burro sería en burro. Ir en burro.
Joder.
No, ir a burro. Es raro, ¿eh?
Y en moto.
En moto también. En bici, en moto, a caballo.
Ay, ay, ay.
Bueno, normalmente no, la gente no viaja en burro.
¿Eh?
Bueno, depende, pues sí, depende del
depende
pueblo.
Depende del país, ¿eh? En Marruecos, sí.
O en las playas, en el Reino Unido. Siempre hay un,
eso sí,
un burro.
En Blackpool.
Para los niños.
Siempre.
El burro diciendo, F my life, ¿no?
¿Qué hago aquí? Hace mal tiempo.
El niño está gordo.
Sí. Bueno, eso es todo. Muchísimas gracias. Y ahora... nos vamos.
Y nos vemos.
Hasta luego, adiós.
Adiós.